Well, Stuart, let me tell you about it. Longest bus ride I ever took in my life. Halifax, Nova Scotia to Miami, Florida, Wednesday to Sunday, Lester Flatt's band. Had to do a matinee show at Gene Christian's big Bluegrass Festival down there. Pulled into the festival grounds, I saw a man who looked like a ghost. Had on a Seminole Indian coat, carrying a briefcase. Lester Flatt said, well, there's Ervin T. Rouse. I said, who's Ervin T. Rouse? He said, he's the man that wrote Sweeter Than the Flowers and the Orange Blossom Special. I said, all right. I got to shake his hand. He had a briefcase with him with a check for $25,000 in it, royalties from the Orange Blossom Special. Couldn't understand why the lady wouldn't give him a hot dog at the hot dog stand and change it out for him. Ervin and his brother Gordon traveled up and down the Eastern Seaboard Trail with that guitar and that fiddle, playing for hat money. Here's the biggie, did Stuart. All right. Well, look yonder coming down that railroad track. Bring in my baby back. Will you talk about your traveling? She's the fastest train on the rail. Will you talk about your traveling? Fastest train on the rail. Ride that orange blossom special. Running down that seaboard trail. Let it fit aside. Some sand in my shoes, or maybe California. Get some sand in my shoes. Ride that orange blossom special. Stuart Duncan.
Coming down that railroad track. It's that horse blossom special. Bringing my baby back. Will you talk about your traveling? She's the fastest train on the rail. Well, you talk about your traveling. Yay! She's the fastest train on the rail. Ride that orange blossom special. Running down that seaboard trail.
Let it fiddle, son.
Well, Stuart, let me tell you about it. Longest bus ride I ever took in my life. Halifax, Nova Scotia to Miami, Florida, Wednesday to Sunday, Lester Flatt's band. Had to do a matinee show at Gene Christian's big Bluegrass Festival down there. Pulled into the festival grounds, I saw a man who looked like a ghost. Had on a Seminole Indian coat, carrying a briefcase. Lester Flatt said, "Well, there's Ervin T. Rouse." I said, "Who's Ervin T. Rouse?" He said, "He's the man that wrote Sweeter Than the Flowers and the Orange Blossom Special." I said, "All right." I got to shake his hand. He had a briefcase with him with a check for $25,000 in it, royalties from the Orange Blossom Special. Couldn't understand why the lady wouldn't give him a hot dog at the hot dog stand and change it out for him. Ervin and his brother Gordon traveled up and down the Eastern Seaboard Trail with that guitar and that fiddle, playing for hat money. Here's the biggie, then. Stuart.
All right. Well, look yonder coming. Coming down that railroad track. Hey, look yonder coming.